used to use is all stuck up now that he won the Nobel Prize.
The Nobel Prize winner tutored you?
Nope. He just did the research and the writing.
Sorry, London. I can't help you. I have a report due on Moby Dick.
I'll pay you.
The whale can wait.
Great. I'll see you in my suite later, study buddy.
I'll be there, money honey.
And no fair. I have a science project too, and I can't afford to hire a nerd.
We nerds prefer educational consultants. And I thought you said you were great in science.
I am, but I really want to get an A, so I'm building a Tesla coil.
Ooh, challenging. But I'm all booked up.
Really? You like listening to all that classical junk, right?
And if by junk you mean the music of Beethoven, Mozart, and Bach, then yes.
Look, if you help me, I could get my hands on Uncle Marion's symphony tickets to hear Yo-Yo Ma.
You mean Yo-Yo Ma?
Whatever.
I'm your nerd.
Contract is up, so here is the renewal. Now, for your convenience, I have flagged where you need to sign. You signature at the red ones, and then initial at the yellow ones.
What about that green one?
The green one? Oh, it's a little lettuce from my lunch. Oh, there you are.
Don't I need to read it first?
No, that's the beauty of the flags.
I need your help. I got gum in my ear.
And nothing in your head.
I'm sure there's a reasonable explanation.
Nope.
Leave it. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm negotiating my contract with Mr. Mosby.
Oh, we're not negotiating. We're signing.
Hey, did you get a 3-year guarantee?
I don't see that in here.
How about yearly raises tied to performance?
Good point.
No, you're outside the flags! Outside the flags!
And I demand a new filter for that spotlight. Somebody's not getting any younger.
That's right. About the lighting, not about the getting older part.
Zach, this discussion is not for children.
Actually, this child makes a point. I think I'm going to review this more carefully.
Oh, Carrie, are you going to take Zach's advice?
I know you don't believe this, but Zach can be pretty sharp.
Check it out. I'm a gummy mummy.
Oh, hey, Cody. So, are you done with my project yet?
You're paying me to help you, not do the work for you.
Oh, I get it. You want more money.
London, there isn't enough money in the world to make me do your homework for you.
Maybe not in your world, but in my world, I have enough money to buy your world.
Forget it. Let's just focus here. Do you have an experiment in mind? Okay. How about you conduct an experiment that demonstrates the principles of gene splicing?
Ooh, I can do that. I mean, I usually buy my jeans with holes already in them, but I can slice them myself.
Oh, it's like talking to a potato. We'll make a potato clock.
Well, why would a potato need to tell time?
Oh, I got it. So it knows when it's done. No, the potato will power the clock. See, by using copper and zinc, you create a chemical reaction between the two metals, converting the potential energy inherent within the vegetable into an electrical current. Potato make TikTok.
Yay! Cody, smart, smart!
Percentages don't even keep pace with the cost of living.
Why can't you do your math homework this easily?
Please, Mom, those are all make-believe numbers. This is the real stuff. You know what? You deserve a raise, more vacation time, a suite with two bedrooms.
I want that. Finally, I can have my own bedroom.
Well, actually, I was thinking one for me and one for Cody, but... You can bunk with Cody.
I smell ink drying. I hope that means something has been signed.
Nope, something's been crossed out.
Something? What? What is all of this? But I brought a bottle of sparkling cider to celebrate.
We'll drink that apple bubbly when you make us a real offer.
Okay, okay. Maybe there are a few perks I could throw your way. How about I bump up your wardrobe budget 10%? And I'll let you keep the outfits for, you know, dates. Should you ever get one.
I'll take that.
Under consideration, and we'll get back to you.
Under consideration, said I'll take it.
Why didn't we agree to that?
I like free clothes.
Please, just throwing you a bone. Look, let me negotiate. Not only will you get free clothes, the pockets will be stuffed with money. Minus my 10% commission, of course.
I don't know, Zach. I don't think I could let a 14-year-old negotiate my deal.
Aw, Mom, what do you got to lose? If I get you more, great. If not, you could always sign Mosby's deal.
Well, you do make some good points. And it would drive Mr. Mosby bonkers.
Which could work for us.
Okay, Zach, you are now my agent.
Great! Let's do lunch. No, really, Mommy, I'm hungry. Make me a sandwich? All right. For a Tesla coil to work, we need to create an electrical field that can power a light bulb without it being attached to any wires.
Yeah, yeah, less yapping, more coiling.
Cody! Cody! Something went wrong with my potato clock.
I can see that. You turned it into a potato hat.
Do you think this will get an A?
Not unless you're wearing sour cream gloves and a bacon scarf.
You need to come and help me.
Fine. Hey, he's helping me.
That's right, I was helping her.
Not anymore.
Give me back my nerd.
He's my nerd.
No.
Hey. Let's not break the nerd. We tend not to be that well muscled.
Gary, ready to put this contract to bed?
Please address me, not my client.
Gary, are you serious?
Well, he talked me into it. Since he could do that, I figured he must be a good agent.
Great, small talk's over. Let's tango. Now, since my client started working here, business in your lounge has gone through the roof.
Okay, I do acknowledge there have been a few more people.
A few? It's been a stampede. And after every show, people give her a standing ovation.
They're getting up to go home.
We never would have come in with all this glamour puss up there shaking her goodies.
Shaking my goodies?
Bubby, please, you sing, I talk.
The tourists come for the hotel, not for some so-called glamour puss.
So-called?
Look, sweetheart, this is nothing personal, but just leave this to the professionals and get yourself a candy bar, but just one. We don't want your goodies to go bad.
That makes a great point.
About my goodies? Well,
you should leave this for the professionals.
Well, I'm glad you understand our position.
I do.
So, how'd it go? What'd you get me?
Well, more vacation time.
How many weeks a year?
52.
That's all of them.
Yep, you quit.
I quit?
Don't worry, it's just a negotiating ploy.
But I don't
think...
Don't
look back.
I want to...
Don't look back. You looked back, didn't you?
A little.
Cody?
London?
This is too hard. It's two wires, a potato, and a clock. How much easier could it be?
A lot, if you do it.
London, I'm not going to do it. I have my old book report that I have to finish.
If you finish this project for me, I'll write your book report for you. Seriously, finish the clock.
Fine, I'll finish it. It's the only way I'm gonna get my book report done.
Thank you.
Cody, I connected the HV capacitor to the transformer, like you said, and nothing happened. I get more electricity dragging my feet on the carpet.
Ow! Hey, Cody, maybe I should attach my clock to her.
I'm gonna need a pin. You need to back off so Cody can help me finish my project.
Well, he's doing my project. I'm paying him.
So, I'm giving him your mama tickets.
Well, Cody's been my friend for years.
Oh, yeah? Well, what's his last name?
Oh, Cody
Martin.
No, I'm pretty sure it's Cody.
See, that's why you should help me. She doesn't even know your last name.
I'll buy Cody all the last names he wants.
Martin.
Fine, I'll buy Martin all the last names he wants.
Forget it. I have a book report I need to do. I want no part of any of this. London, keep your money. Nia, keep your mama tickets. I'm out of here.
Martin, wait!
Great. Now what are we gonna do?
If you help me, I'll help you. I mean, how hard can this really be?
Wait, which wire was mine?
What difference does it make? What should I do with this?
I don't know. Just connect it to something. Whoa, that's pretty cool.
See that? We didn't need Martin.
Hey, French fries. And they're crispy.
Oh, let's blow up a tomato, make some ketchup.
Zach.
Shh, Mom, I'm in an important call.
Nope, too busy. Can't play hockey tonight, okay?
All right.
Zach, I'm really worried. It's been 2 days and Mosby still hasn't offered me my job back.
In fact, he started referring to me as the guest in 2330.
What's Mr. Mosby gonna do? Hire another act?
Excuse me, do you know where the cabaret auditions are?
Auditions?
Never mind.
Oh, okay. This has gone on long enough. I'm gonna find Mosby and sign that original contract.
No, no, no. Can't you see? This is all a show. He's not gonna hire any of these no-talent losers. No offense. Especially you. Here's my card. Here's some call on a school night.
Okay, Zach! We have a problem! Obviously, this quitting ploy didn't work.
Yet. Because I ain't tough. And trust your agent.
You're an agent? Well, I'm looking for an agent.
You see, they're coming to me now. Show me what you got, clown.
First place in the science contest. We're the smarterest.
What's the matter? You look sad, Martin.
Thanks to you girls, I did terribly on my Moby Dick book report. I got an A minus.
Well, that's not so bad.
Hello? Minus. I hope you girls are happy.
Oh, we are. Because you made us do the project on our own, we got an A cross.
Plus. We got an A plus.
Right. We got an A plus the cross.
Well, I don't get it. Your projects didn't even work.
Not separately, but together, they made French fries.
And one of Daddy's investors thinks we can sell them and make a fortune.
It'll be my first.
So, I guess we did good work together. What's my cut?
You said you want to know part of this.
Yeah, you told us to keep our money, so we will.
Wait. Sorry, Martin.
So, I get nothing?
Yep. Would you like fries with that?
Mom, can't cave into Mosby now.
Zach, this is my last show before I wind up doing Early Bird Dinner Theater in Fort Lauderdale. It is caving time.
Relax. Good things come to those who wait.
Carrie, a word?
You see?
I am so sorry I didn't get back to you earlier. I've been so busy auditioning other acts. Just in case we couldn't reach an agreement.
Oh, we'll be able to reach an agreement.
Excuse me, Miss Martin. My name is Kelly Emmett, and I'm the entertainment director for the Glitz Harlton Hotel. I saw your early show, and I think you'd be the perfect headliner for our main room.
Well, I believe I had the floor. Now, in the interest of closing this deal, I'm willing to offer you an extra week vacation and a 5% raise.
Really?
Ha! We at the Glitz are willing to offer you 2 weeks vacation and a 20% raise.
Shut up!
Mr. Mosby, care to counter?
Okay, I guess I could scrape together 22%. That's if I replace Norman the doorman with a wedge of wood.
We'll double your salary and give you a 3-bedroom suite and 1 month vacation per year.
Shut up!
Mr. Mosby, your turn.
I'll take it!
Take it, but Mr. Mosby, you...
But Jack, I can't compete with that. Guess I'm gonna have to go with the other act. He's a comedian. Does a whole thing on airline food. It is hilarious. You can, because of that. Carrie, we're gonna miss you.
Mom,
accepted a great job offer, and we all get our own bedrooms. Thank you, Mr. Emmett. Thank you.
That was odd.
Sorry. Guess I forgot to lose that when I took off my clown suit.
Clown suit? You're... Please tell me you didn't do something that's going to make me wish Cody was an only child.
He's not really from the Glitz. He's my client, Bubbles.
Bubbles. Oh, yeah, I recognize the horn.
He was just supposed to get Mr. Mosby to offer you more.
Did you ever think about, I don't know, letting me in on the plan?
You would have said no.
And wouldn't that have been a shame, considering how well everything went?
Well, I thought I did good.
Shut up. Now, if you two clowns will excuse me, I'm gonna go beg for my job back.
Well, it helps if you cry.
Oh.
I would like to introduce to you our brilliant new comedian. You'll laugh till you plop. Buddy King. Buddy, come on up.
Hey, how you doing, everybody? Great to be here. Hey, don't you love the Tipton? I tell you, it's great to be working in a high-class cabaret. Last week, I worked in a place that was such a dump, they had a sign on the door that said, "Sorry, we're open."
Mr. Mosby, I've reconsidered. I've decided I want to take you up on your last offer.
You have?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Karen, look, the Glitz made you a fabulous offer. I mean, you'd be a fool not to take it.
And call me a fool!
As your friend, I can't let you do this.
Yes, you can.
No, I can't.
Yes, you can.
No, I can't.
Yes, you can.
No, I can't.
We love the Tipton and everyone in it.
Oh, that is so sweet.
Especially you.
There was no other job offer, was there?
No. The guy from the Glitz is a clown, my son is a goop, and I'm ready to work.
Oh, really? Well, Carrie, I would love to hire you back, but you're asking for way too much.
Stuck her fingers in my ears.
Okay, fine. Forget the raise. I'll settle for the wardrobe budget.
No, no, no. Not so fast. I made that offer before I found Buddy. He comes with his own clothes and no children. Besides, he's a big hit. I mean, he really connects with the audience.
Last week I was on a plane. They served me broken like a lamb.
That's not funny.
What'd you say?
I said that's not funny. And you stink.
Hey, listen, pal. Nobody heckles Buddy King.
I just did.
Oh, yeah? Well, how do you like this punchline?
Oh, my God.
Oh, dear.
Buddy.
You're right. He is a hit. You really connected with that guy.
Okay, let's get that contract signed.
Oh, not so fast.
Okay, I'll give you the wardrobe budget.
You want a piece of me too, Toots?
And an extra week vacation.
Okay, I'm done.
You've been a great crowd. You can buy my DVD in the lobby.
Mom, great news. Got you a job. How do you feel about working with monkeys?
I've got some news for you, too. I got my old job back and you're fired.
Was your agent or your son?
As my agent.
That was a smart career move. Nay, Mr. Mosby. It was a well-fought battle, and I hope there are no hard feelings. By the way, just in case the chick singer doesn't work out, I got this awesome clown act.
Okay, now you're fired as my son, too.
Thank you. Mom loves homemade french fries, but who has the time?
I don't. I usually have to pay those crazy drive-thru prices.
Well, not anymore. With the Lightning Fry Maker, you can have delicious fries in seconds. If you call right now, we'll include a 50-pound bag of potatoes absolutely free.
$49 shipping and handling not included.
Hurry! They're selling like hotcakes!
Don't you mean hot potatoes?
Seriously, call. You won't regret it.
Lightning Fry is not responsible for any accidents, injuries, or mutations that may occur while using this product.
I'm gonna need a pin.
You need to back off so Cody can help me finish my project.
Well, he's doing my project. I'm paying him.
So, I'm giving him your mama tickets.
Well, Cody's been my friend for years.
Oh, yeah? Well, what's his last name?
Oh, Cody
Martin.
No, I'm pretty sure it's Cody.
See, that's why you should help me. She doesn't even know your last name.
I'll buy Cody all the last names he wants.
Martin.
Fine, I'll buy Martin all the last names he wants.
Forget it. I have a book report I need to do. I want no part of any of this. London, keep your money. Nia, keep your mama tickets. I'm out of here.
Martin, wait!
Great. Now what are we gonna do?
If you help me, I'll help you. I mean, how hard can this really be?
Wait, which wire was mine?
What difference does it make? What should I do with this?
I don't know. Just connect it to something. Whoa. That's pretty cool.
See that? We didn't need Martin.
Hey! French fries! And they're crispy!
Oh, let's blow up a tomato and make some ketchup!
Zach?
Shh, Mom, I'm on an important call.
Nope, too busy. Can't play hockey tonight, okay?
All right.
Zach, I'm really worried. It's been 2 days and Mosby still hasn't offered me my job back. In fact, he started referring to me as the guest in 2330.
What's Mr. Mosby gonna do? Hire another act?
Excuse me, do you know where the cabaret auditions are?
Auditions?
Never mind.
Oh, okay. This has gone on long enough. I'm gonna find Mosby and sign that original contract.
No. Can't you see? This is all a show. He's not gonna hire any of these no-talent losers. No offense.
Especially you. Here's my card. Here's some call on a school.
Project. The guy I used to use is all stuck up now that he won the Nobel Prize.
The Nobel Prize winner tutored you?
Nope. He just did the research and the writing.
Sorry, London. I can't help you. I have a report due on Moby Dick.
I'll pay you.
The whale can wait.
Great. I'll see you in my suite later, study buddy.
I'll be there, money honey.
And no fair. I have a science project too, and I can't afford to hire a nerd.
We nerds prefer educational consultants. I thought you said you were great in science.
I am, but I really want to get an A, so I'm building a Tesla coil.
Ooh, challenging. But I'm all booked up.
Really? You like listening to all that classical junk, right?
And if by junk you mean the music of Beethoven, Mozart, and Bach, then yes.
Look, if you help me, I could get my hands on Uncle Marion's symphony tickets to hear Yo-Yo Ma.
You mean Yo-Yo Ma?
Whatever.
I'm your nerd.
Your singing contract is up, so here is the renewal. Now, for your convenience, I have flagged where you need to sign. You signature at the red ones, and then initial at the yellow ones.
What about that green one?
The green one? Oh, it's a little lettuce from my lunch. And there you are.
Don't I need to read it first?
No, that's the beauty of the flags.
I need your help. I got gum in my ear.
And nothing in your head.
I'm sure there's a reasonable explanation.
Nope.
Leave it. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm negotiating my contract with Mr. Mosby.
Oh, we're not negotiating. We're signing.
Hey, did you get a 3-year guarantee?
I don't see that in here.
How about yearly raises tied to performance?
Good point.
Oh, you're outside the flags! Outside the flags!
And I demand a new filter for that spotlight. Somebody's not getting any younger.
That's right. About the lighting, not about the getting older part.
Zach, this discussion is not for children.
Actually, this child makes a point. I think I'm going to review this more carefully.
Oh, Carrie, are you going to take Zach's advice?
I know you don't believe this, but Zach can be pretty sharp.
Check it out. I'm a gummy mummy.
Oh, hi, Cody.
So, are you done with my project yet?
You're paying me to help you, not do the work for you.
Oh, I get it. You want more money.
London, there isn't enough money in the world to make me do your homework for you.
Maybe not in your world, but in my world, I have enough money to buy your world.
Forget it. Let's just focus here. Do you have an experiment in mind? Okay. How about you conduct an experiment that demonstrates the principles of gene splicing?
Ooh, I can do that. I mean, I usually buy my jeans with holes already in them, but I can slice them myself.
It's like talking to a potato. We'll make a potato clock.
Well, why would a potato need to tell time?
Oh, I got it. So it knows when it's done.
No, the potato will power the clock. See, by using copper and zinc, you create a chemical reaction between the two metals, converting the potential energy inherent within the vegetable into an electrical current. Potato make TikTok.
Yay! Cody, smart, smart!
Serious. These percentages don't even keep pace with the cost of living.
Why can't you do your...
Gary, ready to put this contract to bed?
Please address me, not my client.
Gary, are you serious?
Well, he talked me into it. Since he could do that, I figured he must be a good agent.
Great, small talk's over. Let's tango. Now, since my client started working here, business in your lounge has gone through the roof.
Okay, I do acknowledge there have been a few more people.
A few? Yeah. It's been a stampede. And after every show, people give her a standing ovation.
They're getting up to go home!
Well, they never would have come in with all this glamour puss up there shaking her goodies.
Shaking my goodies?
Bubby, please, you sing, I talk.
The tourists come for the hotel, not for some so-called glamour puss.
So-called?
Look, sweetheart, this is nothing personal, but just leave this to the professionals and... get yourself a candy bar, but just one. We don't want your goodies to go bad.
That makes a great point.
About my goodies?
Oh, you should leave this for the professionals.
Well, I'm glad you understand our position.
I do.
So, how'd it go? What'd you get me?
Well, more vacation time.
How many weeks a year?
52.
That's all of them.
Yep, you quit.
I quit?
Don't worry, it's just a negotiating ploy.
But I don't
think...
Don't
look back.
I want to...
Don't look back. You looked back, didn't you?
A little...
A potato and a clock. How much easier could it be?
A lot, if you do it.
London, I'm not going to do it. I have my own book report that I have to finish.
If you finish this project for me, I'll write your book report for you. Seriously, finish the clock.
Fine, I'll finish it. It's the only way I'm gonna get my book report done.
Thank you.
Cody, I connected the HV capacitor to the transformer, like you said, and nothing happened. I get more electricity dragging my feet on the carpet.
Ow!
Hey, Cody, maybe I should attach my clock to her.
Math homework this easily.
Please, Mom, those are all make-believe numbers. This is the real stuff. You know what? You deserve a raise, more vacation time, a suite with two bedrooms.
I want that. Finally, I can have my own bedroom.
Well, actually, I was thinking one for me and one for Cody, but you can bunk with Cody.
I smell ink drying. I hope that means something has been signed.
Nope, something's been crossed out.
Something? What? What is all of this? But I brought a bottle of sparkling cider to celebrate.
Well,
we'll drink that apple bubbly when you make us a real offer.
Okay, okay. Maybe there are a few perks I could throw your way. How about I bump up your wardrobe budget 10%? And I'll let you keep the outfits for, you know, dates. Should you ever get one.
I'll take that.
Under consideration, and we'll get back to you.
Under consideration, said I'll take it. Why didn't we agree to that?
I like free clothes.
Please, just throwing you a bone. Look, let me negotiate. Not only will you get free clothes, the pockets will be stuffed with money. Minus my 10% commission, of course.
I don't know, Zach. I don't think I could let a 14-year-old negotiate my deal.
Aw, Mom, what do you got to lose? If I get you more, great. If not, you could always sign Mosby's deal.
Well, you do make some good points. And it would drive Mr. Mosby bonkers.
Which could work for us.
Okay, Zach, you are now my agent.
Great! Let's do lunch! No, really, Mommy, I'm hungry. Make me a sandwich? All right. For our Tesla coil to work, we need to create an electrical field that can power a light bulb without it being attached to any wires.
Yeah, yeah. Less yapping, more coiling.
Cody! Cody! Something went wrong with my potato clock.
I can see that. You turned it into a potato hat.
Do you think this will get an A?
Not unless you're wearing sour cream gloves and a bacon scarf.
Look, you need to come and help me.
Fine.
Hey, he's helping me.
That's right, I was helping her.
Not anymore.
Give me back my nerve.
It's my nerve.
No.
Hey. Let's not break the nerd. We tend not to be that well-muscled.
Help me, I'll help you. I mean, how hard can this really be?
Wait, which wire was mine?
What difference does it make? What should I do with this?
I don't know, just connect it to something. Whoa, that's pretty cool.
See that? We didn't need Martin.
Hey, French fries. And they're crispy.
Ooh, let's blow up a tomato and make some ketchup.
Zach.
Shh, Mom, I'm on an important call.
Nope, too busy. Can't play hockey tonight, okay?
All right.
Zach, I'm really worried. It's been 2 days and Mosby still hasn't offered me my job back. In fact, he started referring to me as the guest in 2330.
What's Mr. Mosby gonna do? Hire another act?
Excuse me, do you know where the cabaret auditions are?
Auditions?
Never mind.
Oh, okay. This has gone on long enough. I'm gonna find Mosby and sign that original contract.
No. Can't you see? This is all a show. He's not gonna hire any of these no-talent losers. No offense. Especially you. Here's my card. Just don't call on a school night.
Okay, Zach!
We have a problem! Obviously, this quitting ploy didn't work.
Yet. Because I ain't tough. And trust your agent.
You're an agent? Well, I'm looking for an agent.
You see, they're coming to me now. Show me what you got, clown.
First place in the science contest! We're the smarterest! the matter? You look sad, Martin.
Thanks to you girls, I did terribly on my Moby Dick book report. I got an A-.
Well, that's not so bad.
Hello? Minus. I hope you girls are happy.
Oh, we are. Because you made us do the project on our own, we got an A+.
Plus. We got an A.
Plus. Right. We got an A+ the cross.
Well, I don't get it. Your projects didn't even work.
Not separately, but together. They made French fries.
And one of Daddy's investors thinks we can sell them and make a fortune.
It'll be my first. So, I guess we did good work together. What's my cut?
You said you want to know part of this.
Yeah, you told us to keep our money, so we will.
But, wait. Sorry, Martin.
So, I get nothing?
Yep. Would you like fries with that?
Before I wind up doing early bird dinner theater in Fort Lauderdale. It is caving time.
Relax. Good things come to those who wait.
Karen, a word?
You see?
I am so sorry I didn't get back to you earlier. I've been so busy auditioning other acts. Just in case we couldn't reach an agreement.
Oh, we'll be able to reach an agreement.
Excuse me, Miss Martin. My name is Kelly Emmett, and I'm the entertainment director for the Glitz-Harlton Hotel. I saw your early show, and I think you'd be the perfect headliner for our main room.
Well, I believe I had the floor. Now, in the interest of closing this deal, I'm willing to offer you an extra week vacation and a 5% raise.
Really?
Ha! We at the Glitz are willing to offer you 2 weeks vacation and a 20% raise.
Mr. Mosby, care to counter?
Okay, I guess I could scrape together 22%. That's if I replace Norman the doorman with a wedge of wood.
We'll double your salary and give you a 3-bedroom suite and 1 month vacation per year.
Shut up! Mr. Mosby, your turn.
I'll take it, but Mr. Mosby, you...
But, Zach, I can't compete with that. Guess I'm gonna have to go with the other act. He's a comedian. There's a whole thing on airline food. It is hilarious. You can, because of that. Carrie, we're gonna miss you.
Mom, what have you done?
I just accepted a great job offer and we all get our own bedrooms. Thank you, Mr. Emmett, thank you.
That was odd.
Sorry. Guess I forgot to lose that when I took off my clown suit.
Clown suit?
Please tell me you didn't do something that's going to make me wish Cody was an only child.
He's not really from the Glitz. He's my client, Bubbles.
Bubbles.
yeah. Wait, which flyer was mine?
What difference does it make? What should I do with this?
I don't know, just connect it to something. Whoa, that's pretty cool.
See that? We didn't need Martin.
Hey! French fries! And they're crispy!
Oh, let's blow up a tomato and make some ketchup!
Zach.
Shh, Mom, I'm on an important call.
Nope, too busy. Can't play hockey tonight, okay?
All right. Zach, I'm really worried. It's been 2 days and Mosby still hasn't offered me my job back. In fact, he started referring to me as the guest in 2330.
What's Mr. Mosby gonna do? Hire another act?
Excuse me, do you know where the cabaret auditions are?
Auditions?
Never mind.
Oh, okay. This has gone on long enough. I'm gonna find Mosby and sign that original contract.
No, no, no. Can't you see? This is all a show. He's not gonna hire any of these no-talent losers. No offense. Especially you. Here's my card. Here's some call on a school.
Project. The guy he used to use is all stuck up now that he won the Nobel Prize.
The Nobel Prize winner tutored you?
Nope. He just did the research and the writing.
Sorry, London. I can't help you. I have a report due on Moby Dick.
I'll pay you.
The whale can wait.
Great. I'll see you in my suite later, study buddy.
I'll be there, money honey.
No fair. I have a science project, too, and I can't afford to hire a nerd.
We nerds prefer educational consultants. And I thought you said you were great in science.
I am, but I really want to get an A, so I'm building a Tesla coil.
Ooh, challenging. But I'm all booked up.
Really? You like listening to all that classical junk, right?
And if by junk you mean the music of Beethoven, Mozart, and Bach, then yes.
Look, if you help me, I could get my hands on Uncle Marion's symphony tickets to hear Yo-Yo Ma.
You mean Yo-Yo Ma?
Whatever.
I'm your nerd.
Your singing contract is up, so here is the renewal. Now, for your convenience, I have flagged where you need to sign. You signature at the red ones, and then initial at the yellow ones.
What about that green one?
The green one? Oh, it's a little lettuce from my lunch. Oh, there you are.
Don't I need to read it first?
No, that's the beauty of the flags.
I need your help. I got gum in my ear.
And nothing in your head.
I'm sure there's a reasonable explanation.
Nope.
Leave it. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm negotiating my contract with Mr. Mosby.
Oh, we're not negotiating. We're signing.
Hey, did you get a 3-year guarantee?
I don't see that in here.
How about yearly raises tied to performance?
Good point.
Oh, you're outside the flags! Outside the flags!
And I demand
that spotlight. Somebody's not getting any younger.
That's right. About the lighting, not about the getting older part.
Zach, this discussion is not for children.
Actually, this child makes a point. I think I'm going to review this more carefully.
Oh, Carrie, are you going to take Zach's advice?
I know you don't believe this, but Zach can be pretty sharp.
Check it out. I'm a gummy mummy.
Oh, hey, Cody.
So, are you done with my project yet?
You're paying me to help you, not do the work for you.
Oh, I get it. You want more money.
London, there isn't enough money in the world to make me do your homework for you.
Maybe not in your world, but in my world, I have enough money to buy your world.
Cody, will you help me with my science project? The guy I used to use is all stuck up now that he won the Nobel Prize.
The Nobel Prize winner tutored you?
Nope, he just did the research and the writing.
Sorry, London. I can't help you. I have a report due on Moby Dick.
I'll pay you.
The whale can wait.
Great. I'll see you in my suite later, study buddy.
I'll be there, money honey.
And no fair. I have a science project, too, and I can't afford to hire a nerd.
We nerds prefer educational consultants. And I thought you said you were great in science.
I am, but I really want to get an A, so I'm building a Tesla coil.
Ooh, challenging. But I'm all booked up.
Really? You like listening to all that classical junk, right?
And if by junk you mean the music of Beethoven, Mozart, and Bach, then yes.
Look, if you help me, I could get my hands on Uncle Marion's symphony tickets to hear Yo-Yo Ma.
You mean Yo-Yo Ma?
Whatever.
I'm your nerd.
Singing contract is up, so here is the renewal. Now, for your convenience, I have flagged where you need to sign. You signature at the red ones, and then initial at the yellow ones.
What about that green one?
The green one? Oh, it's a little lettuce from my lunch. And there you are.
Don't I need to read it first?
No, that's the beauty of the flags.
I need your help. I got gum in my ear.
And nothing in your head.
I'm sure there's a reasonable explanation.
Nope.
Leave it. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm negotiating my contract with Mr. Mosby.
Oh, we're not negotiating. We're signing.
Hey, did you get a 3-year guarantee?
I don't see that in here.
How about yearly raises tied to performance?
Go
Good point.
No, you're outside the flags! Outside the flags!
I demand a new filter for that spotlight. Somebody's not getting any younger.
That's right. About the lighting, not about the getting older part.
Zach, this discussion is not for children.
Actually, this child makes a point. I think I'm going to review this more carefully.
Oh, Carrie, are you going to take Zach's advice?
I know you don't believe this, but Zach can be pretty sharp.
Check it out. I'm a gummy mummy.
Oh, hi, Cody. So, are you done with my project yet?
You're paying me to help you, not do the work for you.
Oh, I get it. You want more money.
London, there isn't enough money in the world to make me do your homework for you.
Maybe not in your world, but in my world, I have enough money to buy your world.
Forget it. Let's just focus here. Do you have an experiment in mind? Okay. How about you conduct an experiment that demonstrates the principles of gene splicing?
Ooh, I can do that. I mean, I usually buy my jeans with holes already in them, but I can slice them myself.
It's like talking to a potato. We'll make a potato clock.
Well, why would a potato need to tell time? Oh, I got it. So it knows when it's done.
No, the potato will power the clock. See, by using copper and zinc, you create a chemical reaction between the two metals, converting the potential energy inherent within the vegetable into an electrical current. Potato make TikTok.
Yay! Cody, smart, smart!
No, 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 no. He cannot be serious. These percentages don't even keep pace with the cost of living.
Why can't you do your math homework this easily?
Please, Mom, those are all make-believe numbers. This is the real stuff. You know what? You deserve a raise, more vacation time, a suite with two bedrooms.
I want that. Finally, I can have my own bedroom.
Well, actually, I was thinking one for me and one for Cody, but you can bunk with Cody.
I smell ink drying. I hope that means something has been signed.
Nope, something's been crossed out.
Something? What? What is all of this? But I brought a bottle of sparkling cider to celebrate.
Well, we'll drink that apple bubbly when you make us a real offer.
Okay, okay. Maybe there are a few perks I could throw your way. How about I bump up your wardrobe budget 10%, and I'll let you keep the outfits for, you know, dates, should you ever get one.
I'll take that.
Under consideration, and we'll get back to you.
Under consideration, said I'll take it.
Why didn't we agree to that?
I like free clothes.
Please, just throwing you a bone. Look, let me negotiate. Not only will you get free clothes, the pockets will be stuffed with money. Minus my 10% commission, of course.
I don't know, Zach. I don't think I could let a 14-year-old negotiate my deal.
Aw, Mom, what do you got to lose? If I get you more, great. If not, you could always sign Mosby's deal.
Well, you do make some good points. And it would drive Mr. Mosby bonkers.
Which could work for us.
Okay, Zach, you are now my agent.
Great! Let's do lunch! No, really, Mommy, I'm hungry. Make me a sandwich? All right. For a Tesla coil to work, we need to create an electrical field that can power a light bulb without it being attached to any wires. The
Yeah, yeah. Less yapping, more coiling.
Cody! Cody! Something went wrong with my potato clock.
I can see that. You turned it into a potato hat.
Do you think this will get an A?
Not unless you're wearing sour cream gloves and a bacon scarf.
Look, you need to come and help me.
Fine.
Hey, he's helping me.
That's right, I was helping her.
Not anymore.
Give me back my nerd.
He's my nerd.
No.
Hey.
Let's not break the nerd. We tend not to be that well muscled.
Ready to put this contract to bed?
Please address me, not my client.
Gary, are you serious?
Well, he talked me into it. Since he could do that, I figured he must be a good agent.
Great, small talk's over. Let's tango. Now, since my client started working here, business in your lounge has gone through the roof.
Okay, I do acknowledge there have been a few more people.
A few? It's been a stampede. And after every show, people give her a standing ovation.
They're getting up to go home!
Well, they never would have come in with all this glamour puss up there shaking her goodies.
Shaking my goodies?
Bubby, please, you sing, I talk.
The tourists come for the hotel, not for some so-called glamour puss.
So-called?
Look, sweetheart, this is nothing personal, but just leave this to the professionals and get yourself a candy bar, but just one. We don't want your goodies to go bad.
That makes a great point.
About my goodies? Oh,
you should leave this for the professionals.
Well, I'm glad you understand our position.
I do.
So, how'd it go? What'd you get me?
Well, more vacation time.
How many weeks a year?
52.
That's all of them.
Yep, you quit.
I quit?
Don't worry, it's just a negotiating ploy.
But I don't
think... look back.
I wanna...
Don't look back. You looked back, didn't you?
A little...
A potato and a clock. How much easier could it be?
A lot, if you do it.
London, I'm not going to do it. I have my own book report that I have to finish.
If you finish this project for me, I'll write your book report for you. Seriously, finish the clock.
Fine, I'll finish it. It's the only way I'm gonna get my book report done.
Thank you.
Cody, I connected the HV capacitor to the transformer, like you said, and nothing happened. I get more electricity dragging my feet on the carpet.
Ow! Hey, Cody, maybe I should attach my clock to her. I'm gonna need a pin.
You need to back off so Cody can help me finish my project.
Well, he's doing my project. I'm paying him.
So I'm giving him your mama tickets.
Well, Cody's been my friend for years.
Oh, yeah? Well, what's his last name?
Oh, Cody. Cody. Martin. No, I'm pretty sure it's Cody.
See, that's why you should help me. She doesn't even know your last name.
I'll buy Cody all the last names he wants.
Martin.
Fine, I'll buy Martin all the last names he wants.
Forget it. I have a book report I need to do. I want no part of any of this. London, keep your money. Nia, keep your mama tickets. I'm out of here.
wait.
Great. Now what are we going to do?
If you...
I recognize the horn.
He was just supposed to get Mr. Mosby to offer you more.
Did you ever think about, I don't know, letting me in on the plan?
You would have said no.
And wouldn't that have been a shame, considering how well everything went?
Well, I thought I did good.
Shut up. Now, if you two clowns will excuse me, I'm gonna go beg for my job back.
Well, it helps if you cry.
Oh.
I would like to introduce to you our brilliant new comedian. You'll laugh till you plop. Buddy King. Buddy, come on up.
Hey, how you doing, everybody? Great to be here. Hey, don't you love the Tipton? I tell you, it's great to be working in a high-class cabaret. Last week, I worked in a place that was such a dump, they had a sign on the door that said, sorry, we're open.
Mr. Mosby, I've reconsidered. I've decided I want to take you up on your last offer.
You have? Hmm? Oh, Karen, look, the Glitz made you a fabulous offer. I mean, you'd be a fool not to take it.
And call me a fool!
As your friend, I can't let you do this.
Yes, you can.
No, I can't.
Yes, you can.
No, I can't.
Yes, you can.
No, I can't.
We love the Tipton and everyone in it.
Oh, that is so sweet.
Especially you.
There was no other job offer, was there?
No. The guy from the Glitz is a clown, my son is a goop, and I'm ready to work.
Oh, really? Well, Carrie, I would love to hire you back, but you're asking for way too much.
Stuck her fingers in my ears.
Okay, fine. Forget the raise. I'll settle for the wardrobe budget.
No, 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 not so fast. I made that offer before I found Buddy. He comes with his own clothes and no children. Besides, he's a big hit. I mean, he really connects with the audience.
Last week I was on a plane. They served me broken like a lamb.
That's not funny.
What'd you say?
I said that's not funny. And you stink.
Hey, listen, pal. Nobody heckles Buddy King.
I just did.
Oh, yeah? Well, how do you like this punchline?
Oh, my God.
Oh, dear.
Buddy.
You're right. He is a hit. You really connected with that guy.
Okay, let's get that contract signed.
No, not so fast.
Okay, I'll give you the wardrobe budget.
You want a piece of me too, Toots?
And an extra week vacation.
Okay, I'm done.
You've been a great crowd. You can buy my DVD in the lobby.
Mom, great news. Got you a job. How do you feel about working with monkeys?
I've got some news for you, too. I got my old job back and you're fired.
Well, as your agent or your son?
As my agent.
That was a smart career move. Nay, Mr. Mosby. It was a well-fought battle, and I hope there are no hard feelings. By the way, just in case the chick singer doesn't work out, I got this awesome clown act.
Okay, now you're fired as my son, too.
Everyone loves homemade French fries, but who has the time?
I don't. I usually have to pay those crazy drive-thru prices.
Well, not anymore. With the Lightning Fry Maker, you can have delicious fries in seconds.
your shipping and handling not included.
Hurry! They're selling like hotcakes!
Don't you mean hot potatoes?
Seriously, Cole. You won't regret it.
Lightning Fry is not responsible for any accidents, injuries, or mutations that may occur while using this product.
You need to back off so Cody can help me finish my project.
Well, he's doing my project. I'm paying him.
So I'm giving him your mama tickets.
Well, Cody's been my friend for years.
Oh, yeah? Well, what's his last name?
Oh, Cody. Cody Martin. No, I'm pretty sure it's Cody.
See, that's why you should help me. She doesn't even know your last name.
I'll buy Cody all the last names he wants.
Martin.
Fine, I'll buy Martin all the last names he wants.
Forget it. I have a book report I need to do. I want no part of any of this. London, keep your money. Nia, keep your mama tickets. I'm out of here.
Martin, wait!
Great. Now what are we gonna do?
If you help me, I'll help you. I mean, how hard can this really be?